All right, so in video two, I talked about the human element of your team and how that's so important to really recognize and understand that if we want empowered teams. The principle today, right, principle number three in creating empowered teams is really looking at what does your team want? One of the things that a leader said to me early on in my career that always stuck with me was that your team comes to work for their goals, not yours. And I always thought about that as a leader because really secretly, if I'm being honest, I really hope that my team came to work for my goals, right? I really hope that the universe and all the people in it were conspiring for my success and my glory and my income, right? That's really what I wanted early on as a leader. What I realize is that people don't do that, right? It's not that they don't care about your goals and your success, but the reality is that they care about their own goals and their success. The reason why I bring this up is I talk to leaders all the time who have no idea why their team works for them, what they want out of work, what their next step is, what are their personal goals, what are their work goals. They have no idea about their team member. And if you're going to create an empowered team, accountability is important. If we're going to create accountability, what we want to do is we want to understand, well, what motivates each individual person? And we have to recognize that everyone has their own motivators. Everyone brings their own motivators to work. And a lot of times when we don't do this, right, this is the difference between creating influence versus control. When we create influence, we find out what each individual team member's motivators are, and we try to speak to those motivators. When we try to control, we forget all that. Screw their motivators. I don't even care about your motivators. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to yell at you. I'm going to threaten you. I'm going to use shame. I'm going to use all these different things that we use to get people to take action right now. Because as a leader, I don't really care about what you want. What I care about is what I want. I don't want to portray that. And so I'm looking at my team members as how do I learn more about them? Now, the cool thing that we do at New Work Revolution is we take our clients through a process where they find these things out about their team. What makes them tick? What do they think they're good at? What are some good relationships they've had in the past? What are the ways that they like to be praised? We go through all these questions so that the leader can understand more about the team member, what makes them tick, and how they can lead them well. Because again, your team comes to work for their goals. They don't come to work for yours. When you can recognize that and understand it, you can start to create empowerment by motivating them towards the things that they want to accomplish and they want to achieve. Man, that's true power.